let's head back to the safe house. I should be able to just go.
Did you see that? That was the first episode of the new season of South Park. When Cartman is
The PC principal?
Yeah, and he's doing all the ridiculous shit, and he's going to unleash Jared.
Yeah.
I'm really wondering what the finale of this season is going to be.
Is this season going to be short like it seems like the last couple have been?
Probably.
I was looking through, and the last couple have only been like 10 or like 12 or 13 episodes.
You should watch the last season, because...
I'm watching it right now.
Yeah. The weird thing about these last couple of seasons is that they've had episode-to-episode continuity.
Okay, that was not a thing. Like, I didn't know how long that had been going
on. Back in the day, there would be references and shit, but it was kind of like...
It was mostly just characters. Yeah. It wasn't storylines. Yeah, that's one thing. Like, I watched the Safe Space episode from this season, which is like episode 5.
Yeah.
That was the first episode I watched. And then it was like, it seems like there's actually... I should have been following along from here. So I went back and started episode 1. It's so good. I love it. Like, I've never been a huge South Park person either.
Oh, yeah. I've watched the whole series. It's entertaining.
And it's one of those things, too. Like, I thought about going back and starting from the beginning and watching it.
Oh, jeez.
But those first seasons are rough, and I've seen them, is the thing.
Yes. Yeah. Well, the first few seasons, the episodes were just ridiculous shit happened. They didn't get into, like, all the damn political satire that they do nowadays, social commentary.
So literally what I did is I just went through like the plot summaries for different episodes and was like, what season did I stop watching, which is around like season like 8 or something like that. And so I've just decided to just start watching like from there.
Yeah, because they're way up there now.
It's like season 19, I think is what's on.
God, right. I remember when that show started when I was like middle school, and it was just this thing people would talk about, and I was like, what are you talking about? They'd be like, you killed Kenny. And I'd be like, who? Kenny? Rogers?
You bastard. Why? What?
Of the delightful host of Kenny Rogers Rotisserie?
Of Kenny Rogers Jackass?
You've got to eat a box of kittens.
That, Kenny Rogers, I'm not a huge fan of Mad TV or what they did, but Kenny Rogers Jackass is pretty fucking funny.
Oh, it's looters, there we go.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
That's what's been fucking...
What time is it right now? All right, I'm fine.
Yeah, you got time. It's over there on the top right, so...
What?
The Take Zombreaks thing?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I thought you were saying, like, the time was on the top right. I was like, oh, see, shit.
The damn looters. I like how somebody comes and replaces those plate glass windows every time. That zombie didn't put a lot of effort into it, I'm going to tell you. He did not give 110%, which is the minimum needed.
The episode I watched from the last season, I think it was the first episode, is when the boys start their own company, the Washington Redskins.
Oh, yeah.
I was wondering if fucking looters were following me. Look! There they are.
They're repelled by the barrier of safety.
Beep, boop, bop, 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 beep, boop, bop.
Don't forget, we could still be cranking out hammer axes. Every time we go out, we can head over to the hip hop.
Oh, yeah.
The bebop and scat skate shop.
Yeah.
And get us another hammer. Because there's always an axe in here.
So, I got to remember to always grab a fire axe.
We'll just have a full inventory of those fucking things.
That's when you get high level, like in game, your inventory is orange juices, defilers, and spike bats.
Is that your raid gear?
Yeah.
When you have to go fight Ragnaros?
Yeah, they do.
You better give us a shitload of experience.
20,000? I mean, I think that's more than normal, but I'm not sure. All right. Zombrex it up. Jesus, Frank!
Sullivan's like, don't you fucking shoot up in here. All right. Frank's like, here, hold my dick while I shoot this shit up. It's so good to me. He's like, I don't want to.
Wait, why do I only have one zombie? Oh, I gave him one and then I just took one. I was like,
who took my fucking zombie? You became Patrick when he ate from SpongeBob. It's like, you stole my candy bar. Oh, SpongeBob. I was rewatching some older SpongeBob the other day, and it was such a genuinely well-written and funny show.
Yeah.
And now it's fucking unwatchable.
I haven't watched any new stuff. Is it not?
Basically, good? After the movie came out, the writing staff changed, and it's just fucking. It has no redeemable qualities.
Yeah.
I'm a fancy connoisseur of fine SpongeBob programming.
Alright, what was that you were trying to tell me about?
Here comes the broom.
Oh, that you fight a fucking. Gimp, like a dude in like a leather suit with chainsaws. He's, like, forcing people to get married in the chapel.
Okay.
Yeah.
That works.
I'm not going to do that. Spoilers, I'm going to avoid most psychopath fights because they're goddamn annoying, and you don't get, like, you don't get stuff that's worth it.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, I need to go grab that
You could leave the axe here and go get the sledgehammer.
Oh, shit. My inventory's full.
Yeah. Axe this place, question.
I'll be back for you, baby.
Oh, yeah, girl. I've been thinking about you all day.
Oh, yeah.
I just want to swing you over my head, baby.
So this is closed, which means I think they're about to introduce Queens.
Oh.
Because that door's never closed.
It got so dramatic. Killer Queens.
Killer.
He's going to step on the back of his pants cuffs.
God damn, that thing's big.
I assume he's going to remember what they fucking are. That was easy.
Oh, yeah, he should know already. I just realized.
Yeah. Stomp that shit.
Stomp this.
Annihilate these motherfuckers. Shoes. Yeah, he knows.
This still works.
Oh, okay. Nice.
Nice callback.
Yeah.
What if it didn't? What if it made them stronger?
Yeah, just get roided out. Just X gonna give it to you, starts playing.
That shout splits the dragon into three tougher dragons. Don't use that one. I miss Blamomations.
I rewatched some of those recently, including that one.
It turns water into wine, but wine into spoiled milk, so you have to say it while you're drinking
it.
If anyone wants a good time, go look up Scott Curse and Chris Straub's Blamomations that they posted as part of the Penny Arcade Network.
Because
for the most part, it's entertaining.
And they're short. So.
Yeah.
There's been a cyberspace crime. Get sharp.
Let's just quote that for Resident Evil. Yeah, you're gonna have to watch them because we're just gonna quote it nonstop. Now.
Pause this video. Open in another window. Nice. All right, I got $3 a spike bat and 2 orange josses. Did I just make that spike bat?
Yeah.
Okay, so it's fresh.
That's our around town weapon.
Yeah.
That's our pocket money weapon.
All right, where am I going? Over all the fucking way over there.
All right. Let's do it. Do 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 do.
Is that Final Fantasy?
It is. I had no idea you're such a fan.
It's very catchy. That success music.
The Victory Fanfare, I believe it's known as.
Oh, really? Officially? In the canon? Or in your head canon?
It is. Like, my head canon is the name of songs from the video game. It's a weird head canon. Yeah, I ship battle theme from Final Fantasy 1 with boss theme from Final Fantasy 3. I think they're a hot couple. Not for nothing, but the boss theme from Final Fantasy 3 is pretty fucking slick.
I mean, it's no Guile's theme, but...
Well, I mean, Jesus. Talk about fucking unrealistic standards of song beauty.
Real songs have curves.
In the denouement?
Yeah.
I'm still not using that right, am I?
Denouement. Yeah, I think denouement is not a music thing. all right, give me your top 5 pieces of video game music.
Oh, shit.
Not necessarily in order, but...
I've been so on the spot.
I would say theme of Tara.
Yeah, which one? Like, from the original or the Metal Gear Solid version?
Is the difference just orchestral versus... Mm-hmm. They're both good, but the orchestral one is much more like...
The VR mission music for Metal Gear Solid is the theme of Tara, and it's pretty fucking slick. I'm not gonna lie.
That's good. I mean, I guess the victory theme wouldn't count because it's so short.
Yeah.
What else? Guile's theme.
you can't go wrong with it, son.
And as good as the Mario theme is, like just the original Super Mario Brothers or whatever, I don't think I'd put it up there.
Hmm.
I don't know. It's good. It's catchy. It's catchy as shit.
Maybe some of the mixes of it.
Fucking. There's probably a Sonic track that would go up there.
There's a lot of good Sonic music, especially Sonic 2.
Yeah.
Aquatic Ruin Zone, Chemical Plant Zone.
Like, I've never been a Sonic fan, but...
I think my favorite piece of Sonic music is Flying Battery Zone from Sonic Knuckles. It's some catchy fucking music. I like the boss music in the Sonic games, too. Van Toosler. Hey, Snowflake.
Bye. Boom, 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 boom. God damn it. Alright, where am I going? Oh, you have a queen. I need it. Actually, I don't have the space for it, so...
Just grab it and use it. Grab and burn. For those who don't know, when you destroy a queen in Dead Rising, it kills all nearby zombies.
Correct.
Because they're like the carrier of the zombie parasite or something? I don't remember.
Yeah.
I remember you had to get a shitload of them in overtime mode of the first game to make the quote-unquote cure, which I assume was prototype Zombrex. Because gets infected in the first game. And,
like, that's what the whole overtime mode is, right?
Yeah, and Isabella makes the shit out of, because not only is she a fire Latino motorcycle driver, but she's a scientist as well.
One thing I did enjoy, because they only did, like, 6 episodes of the game where I was playing Dead Rising 1, I did enjoy every time Carlos or Carlito or whatever is on screen, because they're unsure of his ethnicity, so they just keep, like, switching it between, like, Native American and Hispanic and all this. And every time he comes on screen, they, like, imitate, like, the Mexican guitar, like, acoustic guitar.
I love Mexican acoustic guitar riffs. I thought that was a jump scare.
Yeah, just a really poorly done one.
Yeah. That's the thing. It lowers your expectations.
Yeah. These jump scares are pissing me off.
It's weird that they added that in, I guess, to give veterans like you something to be mad about.
Like, I really don't... I don't remember that from 2, so if it's in 2, I blacked it out. And it's not in Case West, right? Case West is the newest one besides this one, so...
Well, there's 3.
Oh, fuck 3.
What about 3 Hyper Neo Fighting Climax?
Yeah, I've actually watched quite a bit of 3's playthrough, and it doesn't look as, like, serious as, like, it looked in the trailers and stuff. Mm. So, I give it more shit than it probably deserves.
But, apparently, you can hook it up to a tablet and call in airstrikes or some shit.
Oh, yeah, I heard about that.
I think you need to turn it around. The air is pointing behind
you. Underground tunnels. I was looking for a store, but I think I just need the maintenance hallway, which is weird.
Are we finally going to get the maintenance key?
I don't know.
Or the storeroom key or whatever. Are
you fucking kidding me right now?
There's a whole mess of them out here. Goddamn tomahawk missile. Just throws a tomahawk missile at you. They still use the tomahawk missile, or has it been replaced with the Patriot missile?
Who fucking knows? I'm one of those people, like... Do you get irrational... Alright, I have a lot of irrational anger, I realize. But I hate those people who, like know way too much about, like, military stuff. Like, models of tanks and stuff like that.
Oh, yeah.
Like, just because it's like... I don't know. Unless you're in the military.
You don't like military otaku?
Yeah. It fucking pisses me off.
Japan has a weird proportion of people that are super into, like, military and guns and stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a sledgehammer. Even though it's, like, super counter to their culture, I guess.
I think this is here because of the story. Like, I don't think this was here normally. Because they're, like, they're breaking into the underground tunnels or whatever.
Eat food to restore health.
No. I'm not gonna. Frank on a hunger strike.
Blue Frank needs food badly. You like Gauntlet? You like Gauntlet? You scared about this?
I like Gauntlet. It's fun.
I like Gauntlet Legends on the 64.
Because you're super
me great. And Tommy and our friends used to play that a lot back in the day. Not to brag. A little humble brag about Gauntlet.
There's a restroom here. You think
hashtag Gauntlet brag. Yes, please. My God, save as much as possible. You've already fucked the playthrough up. Retroactive continuity.
Oh, for a second I thought I had $422,000, and I was like, that's a lot.
Yeah, that's more than, like, $8.
All right, plot. I think I have to chase a train on a motorcycle.
We look more like a photojournalist now than we do in his default clothes. I thought this was the guy in the samurai armor at first. They got guns and shit!
Yeah.
Like the LAPD!
Oh, I thought that was Frank. I was like, I think we were putting snakeskin boots on.
Whoever's shoes they are is not good people.
It's the STK. Yeah, good characters never wear snakeskin shoes.
TK. Fucking Tonky Kong.
Hey, my man. Ding, ding. Make sure
my man.
You get all of this handled correctly. We don't need no damage. Take care of this stuff over here, because we leaving in a few.
Okay.
Is that taking any pictures?
Time to take some pictures.
Oh, heard God. You. Is this going to be a plot thing where we got to take photos?
Oh, maybe.
Because I remember that was part of the intro.
Yeah.
Whatever this is.
You probably got to sneak around. Yeah, this is some Metal Gear shit. Theme of Ra would be so perfect. Oh shit, you need to take a picture.
Fuck.
You can probably just walk right here. Yeah, I was going to say, they probably aren't looking at you. I like how I did the camera tutorial and now you're expected to take pictures for the plot. I'd say that's bad. The game was coddling you. There's the most sledgehammers in here. Careful, don't run a forklift into these. You,
I was trying to jump up there.
Is it in a non-combat zone? Oh, there's a PP.
Fuck. Whatever. I guess I don't have to get the PP points. It's just
better. It's always funny, the PP points. Frank's like, I'm just busting with PP. Oh,
I guess we did it.
I guess there's just a little bonus thing.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
Unbelievable. It's that fat chump photographer, Frank West.
What does he say to Chuck Green? He's like, literally, who the fuck are you?
No, he knows.
You non-sequel starring motherfucker. Get your white ass out of here. Get your daughter some Zombrex.
Also, I just realized that whatever little hint page tells you...
Oh, God, we're going to fight our way up a train.
Shit.
We ain't got guns. We got axe hammers.
In the regular two, you don't catch the train. You fucking pulled the Danny Glover. You have to get on a motorcycle, chase down the train, and fucking jump onto it.
Are you saying all you got to do is follow the damn train?
That's exactly right. And it's annoying as shit.
Okay. Just don't get killed. Get one of them and get guns and shit. We're gonna LAPD their ass.
Hey,
oh! 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 You never walk around a corner with Frank West nearby. Yeah. Grab that gun.
Fuck it, I'm drinking orange juice because there's 48 of them laying around.
There he is.
Organize my shit.
Hell yeah. We just been upgraded. That's like a fucking Call of Duty gun.
What, you piece of shit?
He knows. I see there are tanks you can shoot. You told him. Oh yeah, you can't reload the guns in these games. You just drop them and pick up a different gun.
Yeah.
That's how I reload in real life. I was going to say, does it have a scope or anything? Probably not. Scope where you mount your fucking digital camera on top of it. SLR scope. You got these other fucking whatever you want. Just bring them to you, son.
The only problem is they have like a little move where they fucking
get their ass beat with a baseball bat.
Where they
because they're damn good at it.
They'll cold cock you with the butt of the gun. Come on, you piece of shit. Yeah, yeah, your friend's brave.
Damn, we ain't got guns now. Shit, Louisville Slugger disaster. And you like blind fire? I remember that was the most effective way to use the assault rifles in the first game, was because they killed zombies in one shot, no matter what. So I would just run out into a crowd of them and just tap the button without aiming, and Frank would just keep switching targets, and you would just mow all the zombies around you down.
Nice. Oh yeah, because if you don't aim like this, you just like auto aim, right?
Yeah, and it only took one bullet for a zombie. It's fucking spectacular.
You're just like constant. I was expecting a jump scare out there.
Hopefully we can hang on to one to make Freedom Bear.
Oh yeah, that'd be great. Or the Blitzkrieg.
Son, that's it. Ambitious right there.
Well, wheelchairs and batteries are fucking all over the place. But I think now we're triggering, because after this, I think he starts, TK starts breaking into like the different vaults. And so you see these guys around more.
He's like, I'll see you around. God, I'm going to edit so many shitty borders into these videos.
That's like that. Fucking out the door.
What are you up to, TK? Just enjoying the land of opportunity, Frankie.
That's what I think of you, TK.
You paid sure to start the outbreak, didn't you? No
what?
Need to dwell on the details when we all come
it's
out ahead.
It's a popped-ass collar.
Come out ahead, what the hell? Thousands of people are dead. You're not going to get away with it.
He's like, I shot 20 people to death to get to you, but I'm just going to talk to you.
Yeah.
It's a big-ass tie tack he's got.
Yeah. It's interesting. This Dead Rising series interests me because it's like the only like a zombie apocalypse game where or anything, game, movie, whatever.
Scenario.
Where like life still kind of goes on. Like there's still like TV shows and stuff happening.
Yeah.
Well, it's kind of like Shaun of the End of Shaun of the Dead.
It's because it hasn't taken over like the whole world.
Yeah.
So it's become more commonplace.
Yeah. But I find that interesting. Like, I find the idea more interesting of like normal life continuing with zombies in it, and then like the whole world fucking ends because of zombies.
The world ends with you, Frank. We actually see his Bluetooth headset.
It's a big ass Bluetooth.
It's immersive as shit.
You survived the outbreak.
Yeah, unfortunately. And it looks like he's up to something.
We should be able to use this train as a weapon.
Yeah. Alright, so we're in the tunnels now, so we have access to the tunnels. Language!
Yeah.
Phrasing. Are we still doing phrasing?
Did you see the little animated Conan O'Brien Archer skit?
No.
You should look it up. Conan's like, because you know he does that thing where he's like, I'm going to go out and do something crazy. Yeah. And the audience claps. And he goes outside, and when he steps outside, it's in Archer style, and Archer's there in a car, and Conan rides around with him while people drive around shooting guns at him.
That's awesome.
And he says, like, phrasing, and Archer's like, that's not even relevant now, and that's my phrase.
Hey, Frank, there's a young man stuck near the amusement park.
Okay. Everyone's sad.
Yeah. Well, she thinks everyone's sad because she can't see emotion.
I love this pose of Frank in his fucking dad clothes just standing there with his assault rifle.
Yeah.
It looks like the cover to a movie.
All right.
Zombie dad.
Zombie dad.
He's going to turn this outbreak around if you kids don't set the fuck down. Oh, zombie dad. You're my favorite 80s zombie comedy movie.
All right. Oh, I got this thing. Oh, I can fucking get back on the train, I guess, if I wanted to get some shit.
You'd be riding that train?
Alright. High on cocaine?
There you go. This guy gets it.
Alright. Where the fuck do I want to go next?
There's subbed out here.
Quarter circle to forward? Is that a Street Fighter reference?
Yeah, it sounds like it.
He must be in the fucking arcade.
Yeah.
Alright.
So, just around the corner from you?
Yeah. Well, it looks like there's an access right there.
Yeah.
Okay. So, that's what I'll do, I guess. Normally there's, like, a golf cart there.
Hell yeah! Son, this just took a turn for the better. Eat that burger.
Yeah, I'm gonna.
Damn, boy. I'd go for a boyga right now, Levi. I'd run into the Boyga King and be like, let me out in Boygas.
Oh, Boyga Brothers. That never made it to this kind of like recording, did it?
This would be the best TFA video ever if it cut like the time we got Ben and Jerry's ice cream.
Oh,
if it cut to live footage of us running into Burger King and me just yelling, let me out in Boygas.
Yeah, I don't think we ever talked about our restaurant chain that we wanted to start.
Boyga Brothers, which I stole from Chainsaw Suit, unfortunately.
Yeah. Well, you didn't steal the fucking, all of the ridiculous specials.
No, I built that up from scratch, so. Like a buttermilk biscuit. Hit that explosive thing. Or calmly. Get that motorcycle, son!
Wait, is this where I need to go? This is where I need to go, I think.
Oh, we're ruined.
Hang on.
At least tell me what kind of motorcycle it is.
It's like a dirt bike.
Woo! Holy shit! Well, this is the is how you get Zombie Genocider in this one.
Yeah, pretty much. Or either this or the golf cart.
Was that the ladder you needed to go up?
Not sure. Yeah.
Well, now you get to turn around and drive back. This is just as fun. Holy shit!
Oh, I see. I was using right bumper to brake, but it's left trigger.
You could outrun the T-1000 in a semi truck.
Oh, this is in-game shit. This is like the big warehouse doors where the people making Zombrex are. They like lure all the fucking zombies into it.
Woo! The people making Zombrex are in the fucking casino?
Well, they're in the city like because they use it to collect zombies.
Huh. What a twist.
What a twist. That's a pretty sweet ramp there.
It was, for future reference.
Yeah.
Just carry the bike with you in your inventory. If we could just have this bike the whole game, this playthrough would be so improved.
Yeah.
And you could, get people to ride on the handlebars. Riding on the handlebars, this shit's terrifying. How do people do it?
No, I don't know. The few times I did it as a kid, I thought I was going to die.
Yeah, one time when I was a kid, like, my older cousin, was like, hey, let's ride the bike and you can sit on the handlebars. And I was like, what? It's like, you're fucking crazy. And I ran back in the house and locked the door and started playing Ninja Turtles on the NES. And I was like, somehow this is worse. I goddamn loved that Ninja Turtle game as a kid, but it was so shitty. We'll never find a flashlight. Have we seen a flashlight this whole playthrough?
No, I think...
There's fucking Legends of the Hidden Temple, Almec.
Oh, Sandy went as a Legends of the Hidden Temple contestant for Halloween.
Which team?
Green Monkeys.
Hmm.
Alright, I'm just fucking... I'm giving up one of my defilers, and I'm fucking keep taking these gems. Because I need them in my life. Also, I have... Oh yeah, I gotta remember I have that... fucking rifle.
Son, we make all kinds of things. The world's our oyster. Hey, Eric's here.
Is he in here?
Rocket's red glare. Oh, he's standing above you.
Oh, I see.
He's up there like fucking a Strava.
How the fuck do I get up there?
You jump on him. You jump. Yeah, I assume you just jump. Okay. That's your fucking problem. What we gotta do with you? Fucking suck your dick.
You here for Evo?
Pussy you, you Revenge of the Nerds looking motherfucker.
My hands are strictly for gaming.
Why don't you dress up as Darth Vader and fucking rape somebody?
Damn.
That's like the end of Revenge of the Nerds.
Yeah.
It's literally what it is. I can't make this shit up.
Sorry, did you see my fucking drop? I made the beat drop.
We just got the inventory increase.
Oh, I love cryopod.
You need escape the escape pod.
All right.
That's fucking ridiculous. Nice. That probably gives you a lot of PP because it's pain. Look at that big ass prince! Lay by that bench.
I'm literally using my bat until it's break. Used up, and then I'm gonna go eat that.
Do the super attack.
Like that.
Oh! The PP! That's the first time I've been grabbed non jump scare in a while.
Yeah. I'm about to go ex-
There we go.
Look at this fucking pretzel.
I like it. It's so big! I want six on each arm. I'm gonna wear them like bracelets.
Well, that didn't work. Well. Oh, hey, there's a fucking. Yeah. Jesus Christ. There's a fire extinguisher right there.
This reminds me of trying to jump on the roof of the park gazebo in the first game. You'd be like perfect. Alright.
Oh my god.
We gotta find a fucking Woo! Tandy computer for him or some shit. He's like, you can't run DOSBox. I'm trying to play Ultima 2.
No one plays Ultima 2.
He's like, I do.
Ultima 4 is the universally agreed upon better Ultima. It's just like, I don't know if that's true.
It has to be. People goddamn love Ultima 4. The Ultima games are fucking impenetrable, so.
Yeah, and
they're
so
The only reason they got played back in the day was people had free time.
Yeah, because there was only one. Damn.
That's an entertaining series of videos. Spoonie, if you know who Spoonie is, Noah Antweiler. The Spoonie one? He's an internet celebrity. He did like a bunch of videos reviewing the full Ultima series.
He's literally here for Evo. I made that joke when we first saw him, but he's here for the video game championships.
Oh.
He's here for Evo.
I thought you said, like he literally said Evo. There's no video game that you play that is compatible with a championship. Alright.
Alright, now what the fuck are we doing?
They don't have fucking Heroes of Might and Magic Championship. Okay. My phone blooped down.
I guess I can head back to the safe house and then you want to call it?
Yeah.
There's not really any story stuff going on right now.
This will give us 5 or 6 episodes so we can just never record again.
Yeah, and as long as neither of us get the plague in the next few days, we can record
or
again.
Or if I just don't get sad and tired, which is the number one reason there's no 10 Bay videos. It's because I'm laying in my room being sad and tired.
Why can't I just leave?
Nope.
I've never seen this, like the outdoors like that. Because this area is new. This
way. Let's move. Give Eric a shovel. He's earned it. He's like, just like a shovel knight. I'm like, I can't get mad at you there. It's a quality game, Eric.
That's a good game. Get fucking take this. Even though you said your hands are only for gaming.
I'm going to dig up some magnolias.
Hey, I'm waiting on you.
He's so Frank angry. Is so Jersey when you start yelling.
Okay. I think I can go back into the tunnels.
Of love?
Oh, hey.
Oh yeah, we can get our defiler back.
Yeah. I still have those gems. So tell me if you see a flashlight.
I see a buffer machine. What the hell do you make out of that? Attach saw blades to it or something?
Something like that, yeah.
If you get in a little golf cart with a survivor, can they ride with you?
Yeah, they get in.
And you'd be like...
That's the best way if you have access to a vehicle. If you have someone who's hurt, then you can get them in.
Throw them in the back of it like a sack of taters, huh? Oh, you can't ride your sweet dirt bike with Eric.
Can we not?
Oh, that would be amazing. Eric.
Get on.
Eric, you're on this bike. Eric.
The button for calling on Survivor is the horn. I forgot about that.
You should just take off and wait for him at the other end.
You know what? That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go find a fucking golf cart because that would be faster than...
You go back to the left from where you came from and there's a golf cart.
Where I need to go anyway.
Eric's a strong lad.
Yeah, okay. He's a pro.
Yeah.
He's MLG, guys.
He's played, Resident Evil. I'm trying to think of a zombie game that might be canon in this world.
Is Resident Evil Capcom?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's in this. Because like, only Capcom... Capcom's the only video game developer in this world.
Probably. God, that would be terrible.
I just realized Eric's being attacked by a zombie.
We'll just run his ass over. It's the only way to save him.
Run Eric.
Have you really only killed 577 zombies so far?
Seems like it.
How?
I tend to avoid like big crowds as often. I should have told him to fucking stop.
Eric, with all the goddamn anime you watch, you can't fucking win a one-on-one fight. Unleash your Bankai. I don't know how that worked. Just pilot the damn golf cart, Eric. There we go.
Alright, where the fuck...
Oh, Neon Genesis Frank West Galeon.
Alright. Where's the closest exit? This'll take me somewhere. And this'll take me somewhere else. So I guess I'll drive the opposite direction.
That was the most confusing part of navigating in the first game. Trying to figure out which spot you wanted to come out at.
Yeah, with the tunnels.
The tunnels were much more densely packed than this, though.
Yeah, were they this big? Like this small?
Nah, they were like half this size.
Yeah.
We couldn't afford the big tunnels. Well, Xbox didn't have the RAM for it. We couldn't get any RAM because of the war.
Okay.
You gotta make a very sharp turn. Oh, there's your sweet nose.
Who's this guy? Americana. Excuse me, pardon me.
Beg pardon.
Woo! Yeah, usually when I'm driving a vehicle, I avoid zombies because I just don't want it to get fucked up and I have to walk.
Too bad there's not a Reliant Robin down here.
Oh god, so I can immediately flip it. That is one of the... Even if you don't watch Top Gear or give a shit about cars, that's one of the funniest, like, segments of a show ever.
And also Mr. Bean.
Yeah.
He's always... He drives a little tiny car, and he fucking gets one.
He drives an original Mini. Like before.
And that, like, that still fucking trumps the goddamn Reliant Robin. Look at that sweet-ass thing.
It's like a police version.
It's a... what's it called? Cruiser?
He has a shotgun!
You mean we have a shotgun?
That's exactly right.
The good times are back, baby! We're about to bring some justice to this mall. What do we need, a pitchfork?
Yeah.
Hell yeah! My dick just got so goddamn hard.
He has a second one, so I can waste this one.
Shit, yeah. Give it to your boy Eric. Maybe he's played Quake enough to know how to use the fucking thing.
Like that.
He's like, oh, I love Quake. I used my Voodoo graphics card. I don't know why I'm making stereotypical nerd shit. Oh, all I do is sit around, watch anime, and play video games.
Hasn't the internet taught you anything, Ben? You can be a terrible person and still look down on everyone else.
That's true. That's how I build myself up. Quick, follow me. I can take Eric in a fight.
Oh, absolutely. Just size alone.
Yeah. And all I had to do is fall on him.
Oh, Jesus!
How did she...
he got blown back by the shotgun.
Holy fucking shit,
Eric.
It's
such a nice little detail.
He's like, the Space Marine made it look so easy in Doom 2.
That's awesome. I don't think all survivors are like that. That's fucking great. I gotta remember to fucking take that shotgun back from him before we get back to the fucking thing.
Well, that one doesn't have much ammo in it.
True. Okay, I gave him the one I was already using, right?
Yeah.
You need to drop your shit to put your hand on your chin, piece of shit.
What?
Where was it?
Jesus! That's some Road Warrior shit right there. Like, which I guess is what that sign was referencing. Yeah. Don't forget your default. Your current one's about to break, so you might as well use it up, yeah.
Alright, so cut through the Americana, and then...
Everything's backwards in Americana my way.
Well, fuck you!
I'm glad you did it.
Yeah. I'm literally just looking for a flashlight.
God, he's trying to figure out if he's got the exotic weapon proficiency perks needed to wield that shotgun. He's like, my dicks!
My dicks.
I put all my points into charisma. Hey, like, yeah, that fucking shows too. Once you woo the zombies with your loot. Damn, I'm going laying into this guy. There's a queen. A killer queen. You could replace your defiler with. Where is this ass land?
It's so fucking funny.
That is a nice touch.
Yeah.
Oh, Jesus. Remember, if they're being grabbed, jump kick them instead of swinging your mighty fucking Mjolnir. Fucking hammer. Oh, there we go. Don't get that air.
He'll fucking murder the entire zombie
his
apocalypse.
His dick will get too hard. He's like Excelsior.
He won't be able to grip it. He won't have enough blood.
Thundercats.
God damn it.
And Frank's like, what'd you call me? Ah, the good times. We have a good time here on the Tempe channel.
We do.
We saved some survivors, shared a few laughs.
Oh, I like coming in to this from the Americana side because the safe house is right here.
Notice that store's called In the Closet.
Oh, I get it.
Hilarity. Maybe Eric will take over the safe room with that shotgun. He's like, I'm about to bring a new wave of justice. Are you going to just throw a bucket in there?
I was looking for a fucking flashlight. Oh, flashlight.
Oh, it was there the whole time.
But there's no gems anywhere around
here. Oh, you make this lightsaber, you're going to have to fight Eric off.
We're going to have to fight over who gets
or
the lightsaber.
Or you're going to show it to him and be like, check this shit out. And he's like, that's not movie faithful. He's like, that's clearly Luke's Jedi base, but with a blue blade. Yeah. What, did you go to the bottom of Cloud City and find his hand? Frank's like, I'm getting shit talked by a nerd.
Oh, God. Not fighting him either.
God, I just realized doing that nerd voice has ravaged my already sick throat. It's Eric's revenge. He's like, influenza, avenge me. He's like, I never get sick. I'm like, it's because you never leave your house. He's like, I only catch computer viruses. Come here. This stupid motherfucker.
There we go.
You can't have it. That's his shotgun.
You take...
Give him the sword?
I guess? I'm literally just trying to see how much ammo is left in it. Alright, fuck it.
Unless we can find a thing to combine it with. It is the pitchfork, right?
The shotgun? Yeah, there's. I'm sure there's other things too, but definitely...
I do love the lightsaber noise.
Oh, and it changes colors every time you bring it out.
Holy shit. There we go. That's a little more canonical. That little Mace Windu.
Alright, are you close enough?
Now we look like Hunter S. Thompson.
Oh, hell yeah. Bitch, you better give me some money from your fucking video game championships.
Where does Eric go in here to those main rooms so he can fucking put Ubuntu Linux on the goddamn computer?
Thought I'd use my last continue. Do you get it?
He's actually giving me some reward. Jesus Christ! Nerd's got money! Eric, you're my best friend. Did I ever mention that we should hang out sometime?
Alright.
Let's go to the malt shop.
The malt shop. We can share a shake and a burger and fries. Alright, which one's
over? He's like, this is the money I was saving to buy Princess Leia's bikini on auction. But you can have it, Frank.
I don't think eBay is working right now. Alright.
Jesus Christ. I assume right now that every fucking recording software I'm running right now is going to crash, and that's it. The TMHL is done.
Yeah,
I'm not. If this doesn't work, we're not coming back.
No, this game's done.
Yeah.
I mean, so. People don't even. We never even talked about Yoshi's Island, did we?
Don't bring it up. It hurts. It hurts too bad. I gotta go lay down.
All right, I'm gonna go. Fuck. I don't know. I was gonna. I was
it's
trying.
The perfect ending.
I was trying to figure out who I wanted to say I was gonna fuck. But then everything was inappropriate.
You know who? The New York Knicks.